et qui ordinandis un subdiacon. Frater, Iacobus confessus ordini, Sancti Francisci et Ticino pauperati.
Ad sum.
Frater Tommaso professis ordinis, Sancti Francisci, ad Ticinum pauperitatis.
Ad sum.
Filii dilettissimi, ad sacrum subdiaconatus ordinem promoventi, iterum apri iterum considerare debetis et tempe, quacumus hodie ultra decipis. Hac tempus enim liberi estis, vicitque votis pro abitirio ad secularia vota transire, quod sicum ordinem succedentis, ambius non licepit, apropositor residire, sed Deo qui servire regnare est, perpetua fabulare, et castitate filo adjuvante, servare opportepi, atque in ecclesia ministerio sempre esse mancipiatus. Proinde, dum tempus est cogitate, et sic in santo proposito perseverare place, in nomine Domini, cui huc accedite.
nos exaltire ignemus,
Deo amus salimus,
ut hos electos benedicere ignemus,
Deo amus salimus,
ut hos electos benedicere et sanctificare ignemus,
Deo amus salimus,
ut hos electos benedicere, sanctificare et consecrare.
Subdiaconalus, seculo et endite quale ministerium vobiscatum. Subdiaconum enimo mortem apam et ministerium altaris preparare. Diaconum ministrare alas altaris et corporatia ad luere, calcem et patenam et usum sacrificii et offerte. Oblationes vergine inebunt in altare, anes pro positionis vocantur. Dedixis oblationibus tantum debit in altare corum, quanto populo possi sufficere, et aliquid putridum in sacrario revenera. Ale, quae sunt in substratorio altaris, in alio vase debent lavare, et in alio corporales pare. Ubi autem corporales ale dote fueri, nullum aliud in te amem debit lavare, in sacque rossionis aqua in baptisercum debit desi. Studete in aqua, ut ista visibilia ministeria, quae vicius, mitide et diligentissime contentes, in visibilio corum exemplo perfigiatis. Altare quidem sancte ecclesiae ipse est Christus, teste humane, qui in apocalipsis sua altare aureum se fidisse perpetit, sans ante cum, in quo et per quem, oblationis fidelium Deo Patri consecrati. Unus altaris, padre et corporalia sunt membra Christi, scigi fidelis Dei, quibus domus, quasi vestimentis preciosis circundatur, ut et palmista, samista, dominus veniavit in decorde minutus est. Beatus quoque Ioannes in apocalipsi vidit filium hominis precintum zona aurea, id est, sanctorum caterva. Si id aquae, humana virginitate, conjugantur aliquo fidelis maculati, credenda essa vobis apo genesis doctrine, quae unificatsi ad momentum altaris, et punctum divini sacrifici in edera. Estote ergo talus, qui sacrificiis divinis, et ecclesiae Dei, hoc est corpore Christi, digne servire veneratis, in vera et catholica fide fundati. Quodiam ut et apostuos, omne quod non est ex fide, et apum Deus et omnium ut ita vos exhabitatus, ut Deo placere vos. Videte humus ministerium vobis statitum, ideum vos et omnium ut ita vos exhabitatus, ut Deo placere vos. Orlemus Deum ac Dominum nostrum fratres habissimum, ut super hos servos suos, hos ad subdiaconatus officium, opare dignatus est, infundat benedictionem sua. Et gratia, ut conspectu eius fideliter servientes, predestinata sanctis premia consequantur, adumante Domino nostro Jesu Christo, qui cum eo vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Sanctisque altaribus tuis fideliter subministre, et requiescat sub reo spiritus sapientiae et intellectus, spiritus consilii et fortitudinis, spiritus scientiae et pietatis, et requias eo spiritu timoris tui, et eos in ministerio divino confirmes, eut obedientes facu ad gifto parente, tuam gratiam consequantur. Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Agite amicum perquem designatur castigatio vocis. In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. nomine Patris, et Filii, et Spiritus Sancti.
Amen. Amen.
Tunica tu conditatis, et indumento legitse in tua sedoris, in nomine Patris et Filii, et indumento legitse in tua sedoris, in nomine Patris et Filii, et Spiritus Sancti. Accipite il libro di Cristo nuovo, et avete potestate legendi eas in Ecclesia Sancte Dei, tambro vivis, vampo defuntis, in nomine Patris, et Filii, et Spiritus Sancti.
Amen.
Accipite il libro di Cristo nuovo, et avete potestate legendi eas in Ecclesia Sancte Dei, tambro vivis, vampo defuntis, in nomine Patris, et Filii, et Spiritus Sancti.
Amen.
Thank you. epistle appointed for today is St. Paul to the Philippians. Brethren, be followers of me and observe them who walk so as to have our model. For many walk, of whom I have told you often, and now tell you weeping, that they are enemies of the cross of Christ, whose end is destruction, whose God is their belly, and whose glory is in their shame, who mind earthly things. But our conversation is in heaven, from whence also we look for the Savior, our Lord Jesus Christ, who will reform the body of our lowness, made like to the body of his glory, according to the operation whereby also he is able to subdue all things unto himself. Therefore, my dearly beloved brethren and most desired, my joy and my crown, so stand fast in the Lord, my dearly beloved. I beg of Evodia and I beseech Syntyche to be of one mind in the Lord. And I entreat thee also, my sincere companion, help those women who have labored with me in the gospel with Clement and the rest of my fellow laborers whose names are in the book of life. A continuation of the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. At that time, as Jesus was speaking to the multitudes, behold, a certain ruler came up and adored him, saying, Lord, my daughter is even now dead, but come, lay thy hand upon her, and she shall live. And Jesus, rising up, followed him with his disciples. And behold, a woman who was troubled with an issue of blood 12 years came behind him and touched the hem of his garment. For she said within herself, if I shall touch only his garment, I shall be healed. But Jesus, turning and seeing her, said, be of good heart, daughter. Thy faith has made thee whole. And the woman was made whole from that hour. And when Jesus was come into the house of the ruler, and saw the minstrels and the multitude making a rout, he said, give place, for the girl is not dead, but sleepeth. And they laughed him to scorn. And when the multitude was put forth, he went in and took her by the hand. And the maid arose, and the fame hereof went abroad into all that country.
Ave Maria, grazia plena Dominus tecum, benedicta tu mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. Carissimi, beloved in Christ, welcome to this Sunday Mass, the 23rd Sunday after Pentecost, and to this wonderful occasion of these two subdiaconal ordinations. Congratulations, brothers James and Tom. Today, of course, marks a very important progression in your advancement towards the sacred ministry of our Saviour and High Priest, our Lord Jesus Christ. Today, as it were, well, when I was a child and a Boy Scout, there was a tradition we had where we went from cubs to scouts. We reached a certain age, about the age of 12, of confirmation, and the pack would be gathered together and a rope would be placed across the floor. And those who were going into the scouts, as it were, leaving the cub pack and joining the scout troop, would be called by name and would have to step over the rope. And the leader of the scouts would then shake their hand and welcome them into the troop. Today, in very many ways, is a very similar process for those on their way
to the sacred ministry. For today, when you gave your ansum and stepped forward, you stepped over, as it were, a proverbial rope. No more are you minor clerics. No more are you laity set aside. But now you have become major ordinands, ordinands for major orders. That step has now committed you to the church, and the church to you. After this Mass, you will be formally incardinated. You will become official clerics, ministers of Christ's Church. And stepping over that line, you have now committed yourselves to the obligation of clerical continence and of the breviary. You are now committed and charged to pray the prayer of the Church, the divine office. You have too, as it were, proverbially taken the next step on the steps making their way to the altar. Now it is your privilege and your honour to not only touch the sacred things, but also too to enter into the sanctuary by right. The third step of the mounting to Calvary is now yours. And from that step, it is your privilege and your duty, and should be your joy, to assist in the proclamation of the Word made flesh by the singing or saying of those readings inspired by him, of those apostles in whose faith we now stand. It is your duty to read these wonderful epistles and lessons from the previous messengers of God, of the prophets, and of those apostles called by him and set apart by him, by himself in his Word made flesh, in the person of our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ. And so it is that the lesson contained today in the epistle from St. Paul should serve as an admonishment, of course, for us all, but of you too, particularly. Hear these words again. Brethren, be content to follow my example, and mark well those who live by the pattern we have given them. Be content to follow my example, and mark well those who live by the pattern we have given them. So does that apostolic instruction from that great pillar of the Church, the Apostle Paul himself, charge us all, but particularly charges you now, as with all those who have been set apart by God and for God, to live following the example of those holy men, of those sacred ministers who have gone before and who still yet serve, who are called to be in persona Christi, to be in the person of Christ. But be warned, as the Apostle goes on to say, I have told you often and now tell you again with tears that there are many whose lives make them the enemies of Christ's. Indeed, those who had fallen away from the faith, and none more scandalous than those who were ordained for sacred ministry, and then have traduced by transgressing God's holy law, have fallen short of that trust for that office with which they were entrusted, to be the servants of the servants of God. We know too well, my brothers and sisters, the damage that such behaviour has caused the church throughout the world. But you now share in the responsibility of all those in the sacred ministry to strive to live following the apostolic model, a life of service, a life of charity, to share in the care of Christ's flock, to demonstrate and teach as much by example as by words. But remember that as unworthy as we are, despite our calling, though despite our weakness, our human fragility, yet, as we have heard in today's gospel, will those who put their faith and trust in Christ be continually rewarded, will always be supported, as you now stand on the third step on Mount Calvary. You now too may touch the hem of Christ's cloak and the sacred vestments of those sacred ministers who stand as another Christ at the altar. You have the ability to reach out and receive that power, that grace, that healing, that forgiveness, that strength to enable you to fulfill the duty and the tasks and the vocation that God has called you and through his church now charged you with. We all of us, my brothers and sisters, we too, also, though we may not be ordained nor set apart, though we may not, by our condition or state, enter into the sanctuary, yet still we may touch the hem of the cloak of Christ. For through the ministration of his clerics, of his bishops, of his priests, of his deacons, and of his subdeacons, you can be touched by him. You can feel the effects of his sacred power to heal, to restore, and to forgive. We know, my brothers and sisters, as our Lord said, ask, and it shall be given to you. Seek, and ye shall find. Brothers and sisters, like these two brand new souped-up subdeacons, have faith and put your trust in God. Put your trust in the healing and reconciling power and effect of that grace which pours out through his church and his ministry. ministers toward you. Avail yourselves of the restorative sacraments of penance and of Eucharist as often and as frequently and as necessary as may be, that his power may transform your lives and enable you, in turn, to be lights to the world in a world full of despair and darkness. Be a source and beacon of light and hope for others. Trust in his promises, as we've seen in the Gospel today. He has the power to heal and to forgive, and he will all those who put their trust in him. And it is our duty and our honour as sacred ministers to serve you. As Gregory the Great said, we are the servants of the servants of God. We are called to serve. We are called to minister. And we are called to be like Christ for you. Pray, brothers and sisters, for our brothers. Pray for our new subdeacons. Pray for all our clergy. Pray for my brother bishop. Pray for me as we strive to be worthy of that calling of service that is our vocation, as we try and strive to be worthy of the office that has been entrusted to us, to enable you to know and to love. Pray that we also may receive an increase in faith and hope and love, that we may worthily serve you.